What's going on, everybody? This is Giovanni from the Options Trading Channel. The inevitable finally happened with me in it on the right side of the market. Finally, it's about 2 minutes until the opening bell for the markets here, and the queues have gapped up over a dollar from yesterday's close. I am still holding on to one call option of the 223.50 calls. They closed at 286 by 293 yesterday. Let's see where they open up today, and let's see where I end up selling. Alrighty, markets have opened here. Look at that. Trading 319 markets. Let's see what happens here, where we go from here. And I went ahead and sold at 320. 320 I sold. I'm happy for that. We are good. We are good. That's awesome. We're completely out of that one. Phil, 320. Awesome. Awesome trade there. Absolutely, without a doubt, happy about that. My original buy order was 264. My highest sell order was 320, and it's gonna go up from here. But I can't sit here and watch it all day, so I sold, and I'm happy with this. New all-time highs for the markets here this morning. Really happy about it. Alrighty, guys, well, I'm gonna head to work. Gotta go back to reality.
2,000 years later.
What's up, everybody? I am so sorry that I haven't been able to get this video out to you quicker. I've been feeling under the weather, and I just wasn't up to finishing this video yesterday. And so it's about 11:34 my time in the morning, and I'm just now getting around to feeling a tad bit better enough to finish this video. So let's talk about this last trade that I made. I bought two of the 223.50 calls that expired at the time in 8 days at 264. Put in a limit order at 290. It executed after hours that day. And then the very next day, the markets gapped up and I was able to sell for 320. This sell right here at 320 was for 20% gain. Altogether, I was able to make 15%. Let's talk about it really quick. I'll make a video at a later date explaining just a couple of key things about this particular strategy, the MOBO band strategy. You can see here the middle chart. This is the 1 hour chart on the queues. Off to the right, this is the daily chart on the queues. And off to the left is the intraday 1 minute chart of the calls that I traded. You can see here that this particular strategy has actually counted this trade as a losing trade, a bad trade. This comes to show you guys that with great money management skills, you can turn a bad signal into a good signal. Now, it's not going to happen all the time, but this is a prime example of that. This particular strategy, you can't account for that. You can't tell the strategy to, you know, sell at X gain and so on and so on. So you just have to get better at managing those trades. Prime example, great example here. And you can see that the high of the day of those options got up to 335, excuse me. And man, I mean, they plummeted completely down to as low as, what's that low? $1.45, went back up and then back down. But check out the 5 minute charts on the queues. Look at that ginormous drop there. Huge drop. You could have made a lot of money to the downside. But of course, we don't trade fighting the trend. And if we go back to the daily chart, you can still see that we're still in an uptrend. It got fairly closer than it has been in quite some time. This was back on the 6th of January when we got really close and almost touched that lower Bollinger Band. But you can see that we've been in an uptrend, boy, since December 6th. Huge rally in the markets here. But we'll see what happens. Basically, in a nutshell, really quick, We only trade in the direction of the daily chart. That's the only direction that we trade, and we trade the 1 hour chart. But thank you so much, everybody, for watching. Again, I'm so sorry that I couldn't get this video out to you quicker. Just not feeling very good. I think I caught a cold. So hopefully the next trade is a green trade. Let's keep this going. Let's make 2020 the best year yet, guys. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. I will talk to you guys later.